Hello everyone, this is my teammate Elena. Sorry that I haven't been making any videos. I actually misplaced my laptop whenever we arrived to our hostel in Kyrgyzstan. But thanks to God, I got it back, and we're here to talk a little bit about Armenia and our time spent in Kyrgyzstan. So, Elena, if you could share a little bit about what we did in those areas.
Getting to Armenia was a bit of a surprise. We were supposed to go to Uzbekistan, and at the last minute God redirected us. And took us to Armenia instead. So we went in without having any hosts or any idea what we were going to do. So we did ATO, Ask the Lord, and ended up in the capital city of Yerevan, and just started prayer walking and praying as a team, and ended up connecting with Crew, which works with college students. And we were able to get involved with some English classes and meet some really cool students that way. They showed us around the country. We were able to love and serve them as couples and just encourage them, as it's been really hard because of COVID with them. Their ministry and everything. So it was really sweet to be able to pour into them.
Sweet. So that was from Armenia. And now we're gonna talk a little bit about our time spent in Kyrgyzstan. So just share a little bit about what happened in Kyrgyzstan, even a little bit of what happened with you personally.
Yeah, absolutely. Kyrgyzstan was a month where we did have a host that we worked with. We did similar ministry to Armenia, where we worked with college students. We were able to get into universities and do some seminars, teaching them how to get better grades, and that gave us the opportunity to build connections with the students and have them practice English with us. They were really excited to practice English with English-speaking, like native English-speaking people, which was really sweet. It challenged me a lot. One area God's been growing me in this year is in evangelism, which is not my natural strength. So this last month in Kyrgyzstan, God gave me a lot of individual opportunities to share the gospel with students and really challenged me in that. And it was sweet to grow. Obviously, there's bumps along the road and not every time goes perfectly. Yeah. But God was there and His grace covered, and I learned a lot, but was also able to tell students about Jesus when some of them had never heard the whole gospel before, didn't really know who Jesus was, and it was an amazing opportunity to be able to tell them for the first time and to be able to continue praying for them as I move on to different countries and back to the States next month, just to keep praying for them specifically. And it was really special that we each on the team got to do that with several different students for the 4 weeks that we were there. It was really, really sweet.
Okay, and so in between Armenia and our time spent in Kyrgyzstan, whenever we first arrived to Kyrgyzstan as a team, we had our debrief. And then about a week went by, and then right after that debrief, we went to this, what was the area called again?
Lake Issyk-Kul.
And that's where we had our burn experience. And what our burn experience consisted of was it was pretty much just the whole squad coming together ministering to God. And for me, that was a pretty foreign thing to like hear or even say. I was like, how do you minister to God? Like, God's God, how do you do that? And it was cool because our mentor Steph, she brought us back to the Old Testament scriptures where it talks about the Israelites in the desert and how they would minister to God, and like how they would all come together and they would feast together and they would worship God and the temple, they were ministering to Him. And it was just really sweet because we got to do a more modern day version of that. So we were in the middle of nowhere, just in this desert next to this beautiful lake, and we all had these yurts that we were staying in. And we had one yurt that we called the prayer yurt. And what happened there was, is there was always someone in there praying 24/7. So our goal was, is we wanted to keep our focus on God, and that we wanted to always have someone in prayer at this time, because we were seeking revival. And it was sweet because like it happened, like God's glory was with us, and like we could feel His presence, and like there were so many things being lifted off of people. You know, people were just confessing things before one another, we were being freed, people were prophesying, people were speaking words of encouragement. Like we were really all together just in this beautiful, sweet, intimate space with the Lord. And I can speak to myself that in my relationship with God, my intimacy has grown so much more with Him in that. And I'm sure there's so many things that I don't even realize happened from that small period of time that are going to keep coming out. Like, there's been things like anxiety, like being afraid to speak in front of people, like all of these things just being stripped. Because when you're welcoming, God's presence into a space like that, as close as God gets to us, like, sin has to go away. Like, things that we hold to, we cling to, like, they rise up. So people would be getting these thoughts of like, man, I need to ask for forgiveness, or I need to forgive this person for what I did to them. And it's when that starts happening, it's whenever we start being genuine towards one another, that it, like, it welcomes God's presence. So we were doing this for 7 days, and one of the sweetest parts about it was whenever we would come together and we would feast with one another in the evenings. I love food. Sure, you love food, and it was great food too. Like, we were worried at first. We were like, should we bring snacks? Like, should we do this? Should we do that? And we get there, and it's just like a blessing. There's honey, bread every single meal. There's so much food that, like, we were just eating to our fill every single evening. But it was cool because we were doing it for the glory of God. Food is a gift from Him, and whenever we eat, like, we should praise Him in that. Like, we should be thankful. We should be blessed because it's such a good gift. And that was something personally that I learned as well, is like, when you're feasting with the Lord, feast with the Lord. And when you're fasting for the Lord, then fast for the Lord. Because one is a gift from God, and the other is also a blessing from God. And it gave me a new perspective on that, to where, like, I no longer dread it, to where I'm like, oh, like, when is this going to be over? When am I going to be done fasting? It's like, no, like, this is good, just like this is good. And so there's so much more. We would be talking forever if we kept going, but that was a little bit about Armenia, Kyrgyzstan, and our burn experience. If you have questions about it, please message me. Thank you. Love you.
What are you doing, bro?
I'm a fan, bro. Look at that thing. Look at that thing hot, bro.
Can I go show him up?
Hey, I'm drinking.
I can't see without it.
It's a fisheye effect, man. Everything is, huh?